Today I am going to deliver lecture 11 in linear algebra on spanning set theorem and coordinate vector by Dr. P. Ramlu, Head Department of Mathematics, MVS Government Arts and Science College, Mahabubnagar. In last lecture we have discussed about the linearly independent set, linearly dependent set and basis by using some other methods, some problems. Before going to discuss spanning set theorem, I will discuss some problems of basis and linear independent set by using echelon form. Later we will discuss about the spanning set theorem and coordinate vector. Echelon form. I want to finding here of right. I want to find here some problems of linearly dependent set and dependent set by using echelon form. Right, by using echelon form. Right. So I am using the row reduced echelon form. Row reduced to echelon form. Okay. Suppose my matrix Aij n cross m. O n here n cross m. Aij n cross m. Right. So this is a11, a12, a13, a1m, an22, a22, a23, a2m, an1, an3, anm. So this is my rectangular matrix. I am taking the n cross m. So before going to reduce this matrix into echelon form, I am going to discuss about the step by step. First step one, reduce A11 position element to 1. I want to reduce this element to 1. For this, what can I do? I want to divide this row by A1y. I am here using row reduced echelon form. That's why I am dividing this row by A11. So that's why we will get here 1. Here I am getting 1. Next, so this position will element will be changes, but I am keeping the same. That means if I divide this A11, we will get some other element too. So the position I am writing A12, A13, A1. This also changes after dividing this element with this. So first of all I am reducing this is 1. Next, what you do step 2? I want to reduce this element to 0. Right? Reduce A1 position element to 0. For this we have to this element A21, AN1 below elements of A11. I want to get zeros. That means this I want to reduce 0. For that, what can I do? I want to do that Ai1 minus Ai into 1. So for this minus, I want to multiply Ai1 into 1. This minus Ai1. That means A21 minus I. Here I equal to 2 to start. I equal to 2 to start, right? 2. A2i minus Ai. Into 1, that what happened? A21 minus 1 into 1, that will be 0. So this will be 0, this will be 0, all will be 0, right? So step 2 is over. Next, to reduce this position element A22 position element to 1. I want to get this element to 0, but what you do? I want to divide this row by A22. Then what will get here? I will get here 1, rest of all elements will change, but I am keeping same that thing. So, if I divide this element, will get other element. I am writing here position element A23, A2m, A32, dadas. Next, what I do? I want to reduce these elements also 0. So, reduce below A22 position elements to 0. Below A22 position element or 0. But this is what to do. I want to apply that Ai2 minus Ai2 into A2 into 1. So That equal to what happened here? 1, 0, 0, 1, 0, 0. Next, I want to reduce this element, this A33 element 1, right? Continue this process. Finally, we will get A11. Okay. Here, where we get here A n m equal 0 or 1. This matrix is called row reduced echelon form. In this position element, we will get 1 or 0. So, this matrix is called row reduced echelon form. Okay. So, let A equal to A11, A12, dadas A1m. Okay. Step 1, I am writing this reduce A1 position element to 1 for this A1 divided by A11, we will get this element. Step 2, reduce after A1 position 0 element. If I column reduced echelon form, similarly, I use row reduced, I am using column reduced form. So, that's why what I will do? I want to do this one. So for this, I want to divide the column, first column with A11, that equal to whatever 1, A22. This element all changes, but after changing, this element put the same. So next, I want to reduce these elements to 0. I want column elements to 0. For that, what I am doing here, A1, A1i minus A1. So that means this column element 0. Next, this position element will get to 0. I want to reduce this element to 1. This A22 element is 1. For that, I want to divide this row by this column by A22. We will get 1. This element changes, that keeping position same. Next, I want to reduce these columns are zeros. For that, okay, you will get zeros. For that, what I am doing here, A2i minus AI2i into 1. This will get right. So similarly, in this continuous process, so finally we will get this matrix. In this way, we have A1, 0 or 1. So this matrix is called column reduced echelon form. Okay. Here, A equal to Aij, A11, A12, A13, A1m, A21, A22, A23, I am taking this matrix. When we reduce the given matrix into echelon form, when we reduce the given matrix, if we get at least one non-zero row, if we get at least one non-zero row or column, then we say that the row is linear combination of other rows of column. Sorry, here when we reduce the given matrix in echelon form, if we get at least one zero row, zero column. If we get, if we reduce this matrix in echelon form, if we get any zero row or zero column, right? So that means all elements of any row or any column will be 0, then we say that row is linear combination of other rows or columns. Since one row vector is the linear combination of its preceding row vector, these vectors are linearly dependent vectors. These vectors are linearly dependent. Why? Because already we know that one vector is a linear combination of preceding vector, then we say that is linearly dependent set. Here we say that this is linearly dependent vectors. The given rows or columns are LD, hence the vectors do not form basis for VM. If the given vector columns are LD, hence the given vectors do not form the basis for VN over F. When we reduce the given matrix A into echelon form, if we get all non-zero rows or columns, then that vectors are linearly independent and form a basis for VN over F. So for using this echelon form, if you reduce the given matrix in echelon form, you will get all non-zero rows or columns. So then we say that matrix, that vectors are linearly independent and that vectors form non-zero effect, vectors form basis for VN over F. Verify the following vectors of R3 over R form a basis or not. Here, S is equal to 1, 1, 2, 1, 2, 5, Y, 3, 4. I am taking this vector. Right? Let R3 over R be a vector space and A is equal to 1, 1, 2, 1, 2, 5. Right? So, these vectors I am writing here. Okay. I am reducing this matrix in echelon form. Here, when we reduce the given matrix in echelon form, we get 1, 0, 0, 0, right? So, first of all, here 1 1 0. So first this one is there. I want to reduce these zeros and next to zeros. So then when we reducing given echelon form, so I am reducing this echelon form. When we give reducing given a matrix into echelon form, we got 1 0 row. These vectors are linearly dependent set. These vectors are linearly dependent set. Right. I am taking 1 0 0 1 1 0 0 1 0. I am writing this row. So okay, reduce this matrix in echelon form. Then what happen? Will get non-zero rows only, right? This will get 0 0. This will get 0. So these are non-zero rows. When we reduce a given matrix in echelon form, we get non-zero rows. Then vectors are linearly independent set. Hence, the vectors are formed basis for R3 over R. Find the basis for the vectors. Find the basis for the spanned. Okay. Basis for the space spanned by the given vectors v1, v2, v3, v4, v5. So we want to find basis for the spanned by these vectors. So this first problem, second, third, fourth. I am taking first one. Here we have four coordinates. That's why I am taking here R4 or be a vector space. S is equal to these vectors 1, 0, minus 2, 0, 0, 1, 2, 3. 2 minus 2 minus 8 0, 2 minus 1 10 3, 3 minus 1 6 minus 6 9. These vectors, right? Oh, this is v1, v2, v3, v4, right? Let I am taking a is equal to 1 0 minus 2 3, 0 1 2 3, 2 minus 2 8 3. Reduce this matrix into echelon form. So here 1 is there, need not multiply anything, nothing will be there. Next to 0 is there. I want to reduce this element to 0, this element to 0. For that, what can I do? This is R third row, okay, R3 row. This is R3 row. R3 implies what I am doing here, R3 plus 2R1. R3 plus 2R1. Here, why? Because R3 minus 2, plus 2 will be 0, that will be 0. Next, 3 is there. R4 implies R4 minus 3R1, that will be 0. Same apply this operation to these rows also. See here, these rows cannot be changed. If I am adding this, you can observe here, R3 plus 2R1, but this will be 0. Next, see 2. R3 implies 2 plus 0, that equal to only. Here, minus 8, you have here. Minus 8, 2R1, nothing but here, see here. Minus 8. Plus 4, that equal to minus 4. 10 plus 4, that equal to 14. Minus 6 plus 6, that equal to 0. This will be changed. Here I am doing here similarly. This row, here 3 is there. I am doing what I am doing here. R4 reply R4 minus 3. So that means this minus 3 times of this. 3 minus 3 equal to 0. First, okay. Second one, 3 minus 0 equal to 3 only. 0 minus 6, that equal to minus 6. 3 minus 6, that equal to minus 3. 9 minus 3, that equal to minus 2. 9 minus 9, that equal to 0. This row will be. So this is one, nothing will happen. I want to reduce this element to 0. But that, what can I do? This is R3 row. R3 implies R3 minus 2 times of R2. Here 1 is there, right? R3 minus 2 times of R2. Here R4, I want to reduce this element to 0. That means R4 implies R4 minus 3R2. Right? If I reduce that matrix, we will get here 1, 0, 2, 2, 3, 0, 1, minus 2, minus 3. And 0, right? This is right. If I apply column operations, here, if I apply column operations, we will get this element 0, 1 minus 2, that, right. Here, this row, see, if I apply other column operation, we will get 1, 0, 0, right, this is 0. So, here we have two rows, so if I apply column operation, this will be 0, minus 2, 1, 2. Next, apply column with this, see, 3 plus 4, that equal what happened? 1, 0, 0, 0, 1, 0, 0, 0, 0, 2, minus 3, minus 6, 3, right. This will be, this row is entirely, this column is entirely 0. When we reducing given matrix into echelon form, we get 4 non-zero pivot columns. 4 non-zero pivot columns. These pivot columns, so that means, or that non-zero pivot column, you get a pivot column, that means, these pivot columns are, that means pivot nothing but important column. These important column or pivot columns are first, second, fourth, and fifth. These pivot columns are spanned R4 and form a basis for R4. These pivot columns are spanned R4 and form a basis for the basis for R4 are is 1000, 0100, 2-1, 16, 0, 3-1, 2, 3. Let R4 for R be vector space. I'm taking same vector is equal to 1, V1 equal to this, V2 equal to this, V3 equal to this, V4 equal to V5 equal to. I'm writing B matrix here, 1, this vector, I want to reduce this matrix into echelon form. This matrix is there. I want to reduce this echelon form by using column operations I'm operating here. For that, what can I do? I want to make this 0, this 0, this 0, this 0 for applying that. Applying operation C2, this is C2, implies C2 plus 2C1, here minus is there, therefore I am right, minus 2 plus 2, that equal to 0, here 3 is there, C3 implies C3 minus 3C1, C4 implies C4 minus 5C1, C5 implies C5 plus C2, so if I do this operation, so, right, all operations, here, these 4 or 5 operations are there, if I apply call operation for this, so, if you reduce this matrix in echelon form, this will be after changing supply operation to all columns, we'll get this these elements. Now here 0 is there. I want to reduce of C4 column C4 implies C4 implies C4 minus 3C1. C4 minus 3C1. That will go to what happened here? C5 implies C5 minus C3. So we will get these rows. Right. Next, what I am doing here? C5. Here, there is, if G1 is applied directly, I am doing different way. C4 implies, here C4 nothing but this row, implies C5 minus 2C4. C4 implies C5 minus 2C4, that will be get 0. C4 implies C4 minus 2C2. This is C5 implies. C5 implies, so you do what you do here. C5 minus 2C4, that will be 0. C4 implies C4 minus 2C2. Not C4, what we do? This 3 is there, right? For that, what to do here? 3C4 minus 2C2. Okay, 4C4 minus 3C2. It will get this 0, this row. This will get 0, this will get 0, this will get 0. That means we are getting 3 pivot columns. When we reduce given matrix into echelon form, we get 3 non-zero pivot columns. These pivot columns are first, second, third. These pivot columns are spanned by R4, and is these pivot columns form basis for R4. So these are form basis for R4. So our theorem is, so our topic today topic is spanning set theorem. Today important topic is spanning set theorem statement. Let S is equal to V1, V2 dad as VP be a set in vector space V over F. Okay. Be a non-empty set vector space of vector space V over F. And H is equal to span of V1, V2 dad as VP. Full stop. A. If one of the vectors in S, say VP, is linear combination of the remaining vectors in S, then the set formed form S by removing VP still spans H. So Vp is the linear combination of remaining vectors in S, then the set formed from so S by removing Vp still spans H. Still spans H. That means if it is any vector of is a linear combination vector, if I removing from this, the remaining vector spans H. Second one is B option. If H is not equal to 0, some subset of S is the basis for H. If H is not equal to 0, some subset of S is basis for H. Proof. And taking that, let V over A be a vector space. S is equal to V1, V2, VBA, and H equals span of V1 equal to it. Let Vp be a linear combination of remaining vectors of S. Vp be a linear combination of remaining vectors of S. That means there exist scalars C1, C2, that as Cp minus 1 belongs to F such that linear combination nothing but there exist scalar C1, C2, Cp minus belongs to F such that Vp is equal to C1, V1, C2, V2, that as plus Cp, P1, Vp minus 1. Since H spans V1, V2, Vp, that means there exist X belongs to H such that X is equal to AV1 plus AV2 plus data AV1, where AI belongs to S. By substituting equation 1 in equation 2, that means in place of Vp, if I substitute this in equation, what will get here? X equal to AV1 plus AV1 V1 plus A2 V2 plus data AP times of this. So, after applying all operations of vector space, so finally we quote here. Yes, see, observe A1, P, AP1, C1 plus APC minus 1. I will take common out C1, V1. Not easy to task, that is, for taking common out. Since we are a vector space, it forms associative abelian property. We will get this inequality. Already we have explained. X is equal to A1 plus APC1, V1 plus A2, APC2, V2 plus dadas AP minus 1 plus APCP minus 1. Right? Into VP minus 1. That equal to H is equal to what happened here? Span of V1, V2, Vp minus 1. Right? And take X belongs to S as that. X is equal to what happened here? This is span of V1, V2, Vp minus 1. Since, right? After removing P minus also, still it is span, so, right? H. The vector span H. Therefore, H spans V1, V2, that is Vp minus 1. Hence, by removing Vp from S, still spans H. Hence, by removing Pp from S, still spans H. Second one, let H is not equal to 0, Vi equal to not equal to 0, for I equal to 1, 2, 3, data P, P, Vi equal to, Vi not equal to 0, for I equal to 1, 2, 3, P, if suppose S is linearly independent set, if suppose S is linearly independent set, where S is equal to V1, V2, data Vp, then S is found basis for H. Why? Because H spans V1, V2, Vp. If S is linearly independent, it's found basis. If suppose S is linearly dependent set, then one vector H, one vector is a linear combination of removing vectors, remaining vectors of S. If S is a linearly dependent set, one vector is a linear combination of remaining vectors of S. Say Vp. I'm taking Vp. By removing this vector, we will get other set. V1, V2, Vp minus 1 subset of S. By removing Vp from S, you get this certificate. If S1 is linearly independent set, then S1 is formed basis for H. Why? Because already we know that H spans S1 also. Already just now we shown that. If C1 is, S1 is linearly independent set, then S1 is formed basis for H. If suppose S1 is linearly dependent set, then one vector is a linear combination of remaining vectors. By removing Vp minus 1 from S1, we get S2 is equal to V1, V2 add as Vp minus 2. So, this we get to, right? If this is Li, it is form basis for, if continue this process, so then we get to any non-zero vector set that is equal to V1, subset equal to V1 is not equal to 0. After removing all elements from this set, we will get a singleton set that is called V1 vector content which is V1 not equal to 0. We know that any singleton set, non-zero set is a linearly independent set. Hence, V1 subset equal to S is a linearly independent set. and its bomb versus per h. Hence proved theorem, right? See, our theorem says that, spanning set theorem says that V over a vector space and S is equal to be an ancestor V over H is equal to span V1, V2, Vp if one of the vector in S, say Vp, is linear combination of remaining vectors in S, then the set formed from S, the set formed basis of Vp, if I removing this Vp, okay, from S, it still spans H by removing vector, okay, that set formed from S, by removing Vp still spans H. That means if I removing this element from S, it will still spans H. Okay, that's why I already proved. Second one, Fp is not equal to a singleton 0 for some subset of H is a basis for H. If I H is not a singleton 0, some subset of H form a basis for H. So this is spanning set theorem. Examination point, it is very important. So this theorem already we have proved. The unique representation theorem statement, let B is equal to B1 comma B2 comma dot of Bn be a basis for vector space V. B is equal to B1 bar B2 plus dot dot dot, so Bn be a basis for vector space V, then for each x in V there exists a unique scalar c1, c2, cn is that x is equal to c1 b1 plus c2 b2 bar let us cn bn bar. Let v is equal to b1 bar b2 bar bn be a basis for vector space v over f, then the for each x in v there exists unique scalar c1 e2 such that this, right? Let v over f be a vector space and b is equal to b1 b2 that is bn bar be a basis for v. By hypothesis, for each x in V, let, I am taking that x scalar c1, c2 such that x is equal to c1, b1 plus c2, b2 plus c, and b1, where c is belongs to F. By hypothesis, I am taking that if possible, there exists a1, a2 data c, n belongs to F such that x is equal to a1, b1 plus a2, b2 bar plus data c, n, b1. From 1 and 2, what we get here, both are same, right? a1, b1 bar plus a2, b2 bar data, right? I am adding this element from right side, both side, right side will get 0 bar, left side will get 0. So, since we are a vector space, so by applying all properties of vector space and do operations, so that means closure, associative, inverse, abelian properties, from this we will get that a1, c1, b1 bar, that's after distributive properties also. Since we are a vector space, this element all belongs to vector space, that means I will apply this operation. Here what I am doing here, a1 minus c1 into b1 bar plus a2 minus c2 into b2 bar plus an cn bar b2 bar. Therefore, since v is vector space, this will be possible. Since b is basis, this a1, b1, a2, b2 an, bn equal to 0 bar, then what we know, since b is basis, it is linear independence a2, which implies the coefficients are 0, that means a1, c1, 0, a2, c2, 0, an, cn, 0, that equal to 0 bar, which implies what happened? A1 C1, A1 equal to C1, A2 equal to C2, An equal to C2. Therefore, for all X belongs to V, there exists unique C1, C2, gamma dash Cn belongs to F such that X is equal to C1, B1, C2, B2 plus An, Bn bar, right? Hence, proved theorem, unique representation theorem has proved. Coordinate vector. Our next topic is coordinate vector. Let O B is equal to V1, V2 dot of Vn be a basis for vector space V, and for each x in V, there exist or scalar C1, C2 dot of Cn not F such that x is equal to C1, V1 plus C2, V2 dot of plus Cn, Vn. Then this C1, C2 dot of Cn is called coordinate vector of X related to basis B. So be careful. Let B is equal to V1, V2 dot of Vn be a basis for vector space V. First condition. For each x in V, there exists scalar C1, C2 dot of Cn plus F such that x into C1, V1 plus C2, V2 plus Cn, Vn bar. Then these coordinates, these coefficients of base V vectors V1, V2, Vn, C1, C2, Cn is called coordinate vector of X related to basis B. बी, इट इज डिनोटेड बाई एक्स बी, देयरफॉर एक्स बी इज इक्वल टू सी वन सी टू, ओ वी कैन डिफाइन वेल और कैन डिफाइन दैट b is equal to v1 v2 vn b is basis per vector space, basis per vector space v, and for each x in v there are scalars c1 c2 such that x equal to c1 v1 plus c2 v2 plus data cn vapor, then c1 c2 data cn is called coordinate vector. Earlier I used it here column vector, here I am using here row vector. Same, it is also denoted by xb, therefore xb is equal to c1 c2 data cn, right? So if we find anywhere here, this is nothing but the coordinate vector of x related to basis b. If find anything xb in the notation, you have to remember that the coordinate vector of x related to basis b. Problem, let b is equal to 1 plus t square plus comma t plus t square plus comma 1 plus 2t plus t is the basis, then find coordinate vector of p of t is the basis for v, then we have to find one vector of p of t 1 plus 4t plus 7t square related to basis b. Aim, let b is given 1 plus this practice problem, that's why I'm writing aim here. Let b is equal to 1 plus t square comma t plus t square comma 1 plus 2t plus t square is basis per vector space b, then to find coordinate vector of p of t that equal to 1 plus 4t plus 7t square relative to basis b. Okay, relative to basis b. Principles, basis, coordinate vector. Method, P2R will be a vector space and b is equal to 1 plus t square plus t plus t square plus 1 plus 2t plus t square be a basis for P2R and p of t is equal to 1 plus 4t plus 7t square. Now I am considering that p of t is equal to a1 v1 plus a2 v2 plus a3 v1. P of t is equal to a1 times of p1 of t plus a2 times of p2 of t plus a3 and p over a1 a2 a3 plus 2 r. Here p of t nothing but 1 plus 4t plus 7t square, that equal to a1 p1 nothing but 1 plus t square, p2 t nothing but t plus t square, p3 nothing but 1 plus 2t square. If I simplify this, so by this all element belongs to vector space, that's why it satisfies all properties of vector space. For the reason I'm what I'm doing here, I'm taking common out constant terms. First of all, a1 plus a3, here I multiply extra value of will constant a1 plus a3 plus a1 sorry a2 plus 2a3t plus a1 plus a2 plus a3t square, right? Here both side compare the coefficients of the powers of t, that means the constant term is a1 plus a3 equal to 1, next to a2 plus a2 is equal to 4, a1 plus a2 plus a3 equal to 7. From 1 and 3 I will get a2, this is a1 plus a3 nothing but a1 plus a3 number 1, that equal to a2 plus 1 equal to 7, a2 equal to 6. If a2 is equal to 6, so then a3 substitute this value is 2, a3 equal to what happened? Minus 1. 6 plus 2a3 equal to 4, that equal to a3 equal to minus 1. Substitute this value in 1, a2 1 equal to 7. This implies p of t is equal to 2 p1 of t plus 6 p2 of t minus 1 p3 of t. The coordinate vector of p of t relative to basis b is xb, that equal to what happened? 2, 6. Result, let b is equal to 1 plus t plus 1 plus t square plus t square plus 1 plus 2t plus t square is the basis for p2 over r, then the coordinate vector p of t related to basis b is xb, that equal to 2 6 minus 1. Okay, practical problem 5, let b is equal to 1 minus t square minus t comma t minus t square comma 2 minus t plus t square is basis for p2 over r, then find coordinate vector of p of t that equal to 1 plus 3t minus 6t relative to basis b. Same problem, here quickly I am explaining here. Let b is equal to 1 minus t square comma t minus t square 2 minus t plus t square is basis for p2 over r, then to find coordinate vector of p of t 1 plus 3t minus 6t square related to basis b. Principle, basis, coordinate vector. The method, p of t is equal to a1 p1 of t plus a2 p2 of t plus a3 p of t, where a1 a2 a3 belongs to r. Here p of t nothing but to p plus 3t minus 6t square, a1 p1 nothing but 1 minus t square, a2 p2 nothing but t minus t square, a3 p3 nothing but 2 minus t minus 2 minus t plus t square. If I multiply this, what happen? A1 minus a1 t square, a2 minus a2 t square, After simplifying that arrangement, since we have vector space, so it can be possible. Apply associative and property, sorry. Associative and Abelian property and distributive law property. So here what we get here, a1 plus 2a3 plus a2 minus a3 to t plus minus a1 minus a2 plus a3 t square. a1 plus 2a3 is equal to 1. Here I am comparing coefficients of this polynomial. Here the constant term is 1. Next term a2 minus a3 equal to 3. Next to this is equal to 3. Here from this, what I am doing here, I am taking common minus a1, from I am taking this equation, I am taking common out of this here, a1 plus a2 minus a3 is equal to minus 6. a2 minus a3 is equal to what we are now, 3, which implies a1 equal to 3 will get. If I simply a1 plus 3 equal to minus 6, minus 1 cancel out, a1 minus a3 equal to 3, minus 7, here what you get, minus 1 cancel out, a1 plus a3 equal to 6, so a1, 3 comes this side, 6 minus 3 equal to a1, that equal to 3. Okay, this is one way. A1 equal 3, I substitute here a1 equal 3, then what happened? 3 plus 2a3 equal to 1, 2a3 equal to minus 2, a3 equal to minus 1. I substitute a3 equal to here, a3 equal to, in this equation, a2 equal to. So, that means, p of t is equal to 3p1 of t plus 2p2 of t minus 1 into p3 of t. The coordinate vector of p of t relative to basis b is xb, that equal to 3 to minus 1. So, this is the problem. Right? Result. B is equal to 1 minus t square, t minus t square, 2 minus t plus t square is basis for p2 over r. Then the coordinate vector p of t related to basis b is xb, that equal to 3 to minus 1. Find the coordinate vector xb of x related to basis b, that equal to b1, b2, that is bm. Here b1 nothing but 1 minus 2. B2 nothing but 3 minus 5. Okay, I am taking that x equal to 1 minus 1. Find the coordinate vector xb for x relative basis b, this is given. Next to 2, b2, b1 nothing but this and b2 nothing but this, x equal to this. Next to b1, b2, b3 nothing but this and x equal to this. Next to b1 this, b2 this, b3 this, x equal to this. Alright. Here, let R3 over R2 over R be a vector space. R2 over R be a vector space. Given basis is B1, B1, B1 and B2 bar. Where B1 equal to this and B2 equal to this, x equal to this. Consider x is equal to A1, B1 bar plus A2, B2 bar. I am considering that x equal to A1, B1 bar plus A2, B2 bar. X nothing but minus 1, 1, comma A1, B1 nothing but 1 minus 2, B2 nothing but this. Multiply these two here, then A1 minus 2A1 plus 3A2 minus 5. So adding these two matrices here, minus 1, 1, comma is equal to A1 plus 3A2 minus 2A1 minus 5A2. A1 plus 3A2 is equal to minus 1, minus 2A1 minus 5A2 is equal to 1. If I simplify this relation, right, what can I do? I want to multiply equation 1 by 2 and adding to equation 2. 2a1 plus 6a2 minus 2. So here 2a1 minus 5a1. I was after I am adding this, this will get cancelled out to a2 is equal to 6a2 minus 5a2 equal to a2, that equal to minus 1. Here a1 plus 3 into minus 1, that equal to minus 1. That equal to minus 1, right? I was after this value in 1. What happened here? A1 plus 3 into minus 1, that equal to minus 1, a1 minus 3, that equal to minus 1, a1 equal to 2. Therefore, 1 minus 1 comma 1 equal to 2 times of 1 minus 2 plus minus 1 plus 3 comma 4. The coordinate vector of xb of x related to basis b is 2 comma minus 1. Right. Next two. Let R2 over R be a basis vector space. Given basis is b1 bar and b2 bar, where b1 equal to this and b2 equal to this, x equal to this. Consider x into a1 b1 bar, a2 b bar. I multiply b1 nothing but 1 minus 4, x2 nothing but minus 1 minus 6, a2 nothing but a2, and b2 nothing but 2 minus 3. Multiply adding this a1 minus plus 2a3 minus 4a1 2a3 and we'll get two equations a1 plus 2a equal minus 1 minus 4a1 minus 3a equal 6. I'm solving this, I want to multiply this equation by 4 and adding to this, we'll get a2 equal to minus 2 and a1 equal to 12. So a1 equal to 3. Therefore, 1 minus 1, 6 is equal to 3 times of 1 minus 4 minus 2, 2 minus 3. Therefore, coordinate vector xb of x relative to given basis b is 3 minus 2. Let R3 over R be a vector space, R3 over R be a vector space, given basis b is equal to b1, b2, b1, where b1 equal to this, b2 equal to this, b3 equal to, and x equal to 2 minus 6. Consider x equal to a1 b1 bar plus a2 b2 bar plus a3 b1. Here x nothing but 2 minus 9, 6, b1 nothing but 1 minus 1 minus 3, b2 nothing but this, and b3 nothing but this. Here multiply, add this matrix, we will get here a1 minus 3 a2 plus 3 a3 minus a1 plus 4 a2 minus 2 a3 minus 3 a1 minus plus 9 a2 plus 4 a3. Adding this, compare this rows, what happened? A1 minus 3 a2 plus a3 is equal to 2. Minus a1 plus 4a2 minus 3a3 equal to minus 9. Minus 3a1 plus 9a2 plus 4a3 equal to 6. So 1 and adding 1 plus 2 will get to equation here 2 plus a3 equal to minus a1. Here what I am doing here, I multiply equation equation 1 by 3, I am adding 2 equation 3. We will get other equation 3a2 equal to 4. What I am doing here now, a2 plus a3, simply solve 1 and 3, right, we will get other equations, so, what we will get here, simply what you is here, 9a2 minus 3a1, a2 plus a3. Anyway, solve 1 and 3. The finally we will get the values, or a2 is equal to minus 16 by 3 and a1 is equal to minus 3 by 3, that equal to minus 133. So other value, one value, other value is a2 is equal to this, so a3 is equal to 12 by 13 by solving this inequality, right? This is something is missing. If I solve 1 and 3, 1 and 2, we will get that a3 equal to 12 by 13. If I substitute this value, any value, then we will get here a2 equal to minus 16, 3 by 13, and a1 equal to this value. Therefore, 2 minus 9, 6 is equal to 130, minus 133, 1 minus 13, minus 63 by 13, minus 3, 4, 9, plus 12 by 13, 3 minus 2. So, the coordinate vector of xb of x relative basis b is minus 133, minus 63 by 13, 12 by 13. Other problem. Let R3 over R be vector space B is equal to B1, B2, B3, where B1 is equal to 1, 1, 3, B2 is equal to 2, 0, 8, B3 is equal to 1, minus 1, 3, and X is equal to 0, 0, 2. Consider X is equal to A1, B1 bar plus A2, B2 bar plus A3, B3 bar. Here X nothing but 0, 0, 2, A1 is A1, B1 nothing but 1, 1, 3, A2, B2 nothing but 2, 0, 8, A3 into B3 nothing but 1, minus 1. If I multiply and adding, we will get 3 equations. So, this 1, 2, 3 equation. By solving 1 and 2, we will get here a1, a2 is equal to 1, a1 equal to minus 1, and a3 equal to minus 1, right, by using this. So, therefore, we written as here 0, 0, 2, that equal to minus 1, 1, 3, that equal to plus 1, 2, 0, minus 1, 1, minus 1, 3, that equal to xb, that equal to minus 1, 1, minus 1, right. So, this is the coordinate matrix of x relative basis b. Yeah. Find the vector x determined by the given coordinate vectors xb and given basis b. Find the vector x determined by the given coordinate vectors xb and given basis b. Here we have to find x. It is easy task. Here b is equal to 3 minus 5 minus 4 6. Xb is equal to this. Here b is equal to 3 2 minus 4 1. Xb is equal to this. This, right. So why? Because it is easy. Why? Because already we know that value. So let me take that R2 will be a vector space. Given basis is B for R2 and coordinate is XB. We know that एक्स बी इक्वल फाइव थ्री, नथिंग बट एक्स पाई बी वन प्लस बी टू बार। बी वन बनाने के बाद थ्री माइनस फाइव बी टू बार बनने में माइनस फोर बाई सिक्स। एक्स इक्वल फाइव बी वन, बी वन ऑलरेडी वी नो दैट फाइव इक्वल दैट एक्स इक्वल व्हाट हैपन, वे मल्टीप्लाई दिस फाइव इंटू थ्री इक्वल फिफ्टीन माइनस ट्वेंटी फाइव प्लस थ्री इंटू माइनस फोर माइनस टू बाई एट। सो एड इन दिस विल गेट एक्स इक्वल सेवन माइनस टास्क गिवन आर टू आर आर द वेक्टर स्पेस, सो बीटा इज बेसिस दिस एंड बेसिस फॉर दिस इज बेसिस फॉर आर टू आर आर एंड कोऑर्डिनेट वेक्टर फॉर रिलेटेड बेसिस बी इज माइनस टू कॉमा फाइव। x b is equal to 2 5, we know that x is equal to what happened 2 b 1 plus 5 b 2, b 1 nothing but already we know that 3 2, b 1 b 2 nothing but minus 4 5. So if I multiply add we will get x is equal to minus 2. Let again R3 were a vector space, b is equal to this basis for R3, x is equal to f, we know that x is equal to, simply can write it 1 into this, 0 into this, 3 into this, so finally we get x is equal to minus 8 4 1. Let R3 OR be a vector space and given basis B for R3 and XB is equal to minus 3, 2, minus 1. X is equal to simply can write it X3 minus this vector, 2 with this vector, 3 with this vector. If I multiply adding, we will get X is equal to 8, minus 6, minus 2. Right. So these, so, and this spanning sets are coordinate vectors. So we have to solve other problems in coordinate vectors also tomorrow class. So thank you for watching my lecture.